Chào mừng quý vị quay trở lại với phần cuối của chương trình Tôi Việt Nam với cuộc trò chuyện với ông John Labrie, là phó hiệu trưởng đào tạo sau đại học của Đại học Northeastern Hoa Kỳ. Welcome back.
Thank you.
So are you saying it's always better to for a learner when they go to like a master degree or a graduate courses when they already have some working experience?
It's not always the case, but especially when we're working with individuals who are interested in getting a graduate degree to advance their career in business and in industry, we do find that some work experience is very, very helpful. Mm. It grounds the student in understanding for them to apply in the classroom.
Mm-hmm. I mean, from your experience, do you see that the student or the learner, when they participated in the graduate courses from Northeastern, especially the leadership program, mm-hmm. and when they come out of it, they chose a different career path?
Well, I think that every time you have a transformational activity right. In your life, new ideas come into your head.
Sure.
Let me use myself as my own personal experience.
Okay.
I was working for a university doing international programs. Mm-hmm. And finished my doctorate in education. And that's when I decided that I wanted to leave that institution for another institution and become a dean. I moved to Canada, to Vancouver, British Columbia, where I worked for a period of time at a university there. Mm. And the educational program that I went through for my doctoral degree really was the impetus to me understanding that I wanted to have a career change.
Okay.
So it is common for people who start studying to really want to apply those new skills into a different industry. But we also find that many, many, many of our students actually don't leave the company or the organization that they're currently in, but are promoted. They mm-hmm. are seen as holding many more skills and better able to bring groups of people together and be much more effective mm-hmm. within their organization. Because most people don't like the disruption of leaving one organization for another. And so we see really those two scenarios where some students do move on to other companies, but in many cases, they become much more effective and are promoted within the company that they're in.
I mean, it's a big, big problem right now in the Vietnam's education industry. Is the gap between school and reality.
Yeah.
I mean, students graduated from school and they don't meet the requirement from the employers.
Right.
I mean, at some level that happened in the US too, right?
Yes.
I mean, in your opinion, what are some of the first steps that we can do to solve the problem?
So this was a major concern of mine going back 4 and 5 years.
Mm.
As an educator, we know that most students come to our programs because they want a better job or
yeah.
they want a better life.
Mm-hmm.
And if we cannot prepare them for that better life or that better job through practical skills and practical education that they can apply in the workforce,
mm-hmm.
then we're failing.
Sure.
And so one of the things that we have done a great deal of is, and we did it last year when we entered Vietnam, is we went out not only talking to universities, but we also talked to the business community.
Mm-hmm.
We talked to a number of businesses here in Vietnam, some of whom we had a relationship with. For
mm-hmm.
example, we had a relationship with IBM,
mm-hmm.
and we talked with them about what they needed in the workplace. And we regularly, as an institution at Northeastern, will go and not only talk to students about what they would like out of their education, but we also talk to the businesses. So we have a very deep understanding of what those businesses really need right away. The other thing that has been part of Northeastern's story mm. in the United States, which has made us very, very successful,
mm-hmm.
We lead the United States in placing our students in jobs within their degree programs within 6 months of graduating from Northeastern.
Mm.
And that's been one of the biggest ways that Northeastern has excelled in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
And we believe that co-op education, that working in an enterprise and working at an institution, at a university at the same time,
mm-hmm.
is a very powerful way to learn.
Mm-hmm.
And so as we work with graduate programs that have students in the classroom who are also working adults. They come to the table with very practical issues that they want to solve. And through the help of their faculty and other students, they learn to solve those problems. So all of our courses are infused mm-hmm. with very practical understanding of how business is done on a day-to-day basis. And we believe that education is only powerful if it actually achieves the goals of what most students want. And mm-hmm. most students want a better life, and most students want a better job.
Sure.
And so we really map to that. That doesn't mean to say that the theoretical education, that understanding of literature mm. and of culture is not important. But at the graduate level for working adults, mm-hmm. it really is about that next position and giving a student the skills that they need to succeed for the next 25 years of their
sure.
career.
For Vietnamese students who join this program, Leadership, mm-hmm. Master Science of Northeastern, would there be an opportunity for them to do some exchange work in the state? I mean, would there be a chance for them to actually go to the state?
We accept many international students
okay.
at Northeastern, and yeah. we would be happy to receive more international students from mm-hmm. Vietnam, including those students that will be here. So we're just getting started.
Okay.
Many students in Vietnam, because of the tuition that we are charging for the mm-hmm. program, will not have the financial means to travel to the United States.
Sure.
However, because they're students at Northeastern University and they will be in a program here, it will become much easier to become a member of that Northeastern network.
I can imagine. So and you're part of the school already, right?
Right. So we are looking very much to developing an alumni network here with a deeper understanding of how to support each other in that field. This is what American universities have done very, very well at.
Yep.
As an American institution, and I know that you studied in the U.S. for mm-hmm. a period of time, the alumni communities of these institutions are very powerful,
yep.
even long after the school has finished delivering courses.
Yep, so. Definitely. Well, I look forward to see more cooperation from Northeastern with the Vietnamese universities
yeah.
in the future. Thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you very much for having me on.
Thank you so much.
Right.
Thưa quý vị, vừa rồi là những chia sẻ của tiến sĩ John Labrie, là phó hiệu trưởng đào tạo sau đại học của Đại học Northeastern, tiểu bang Massachusetts của Hoa Kỳ. Và đến đây thì chương trình Tôi và Việt Nam cũng sẽ được khép lại. Quý vị có thể xem lại chương trình trên trang web của kênh FBNC tại địa chỉ là fbnc.vn. Một lần nữa cảm ơn quý vị đã theo dõi và hẹn gặp lại quý vị trong những chương trình kỳ sau.